and be like, actually, f- you, I'm making you eat my and buy me a bag. And I was like, whoa.
We are now joined by the lovely Leah McSweeney. Welcome, Leah. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
So tell us, what has this season been like so far? Obviously, we've been kind of in quarantine the whole time since it premiered, but...
All in all, the experience has been really good. Obviously, I mean, I've been received well, which is really nice because I cannot imagine being hated by the world during a pandemic. That would be too much for me.
Oh my gosh.
Yep. Definitely.
Like, I don't know how Sutton's doing it.
What were some of your first impressions of the women, and was there anyone that really surprised you?
I was surprised that me and Luann connected so much at first, and like I actually don't even think you can, but it was more like a feeling, you know, that me and her like had with each other. Like I just got a very warm vibe from her. Of course, you know, Ramona was really, even though she was being like her annoying self telling me to clean and stuff, she was still pretty, like she wasn't giving me a crazy hard time, you know, like right. She was being like funny about it all with me, and I didn't take any offense to any of it. But that will change as the season goes on. Sonja, I thought me and her were gonna click sooner, but there was some friction, obviously, me not understanding her Morgan stuff and things like that. And Dorinda, you know, me and her took a few episodes as well to kind of get on the same page.
That's one kind of fun thing I think so far that we've already seen is that you and your relationship with Tinsley specifically brings kind of a fresh vibe to the show that we maybe haven't really seen, or at least not in a while.
Right.
And so how do you think that kind of caused friction with some of the other women? We've seen it with Sonja and certainly with Dorinda.
I mean, look, I think there's obviously a generational gap, clearly. I mean, that's not a diss. I mean, I was born after them. Like, that's really it. I mean, and one day I'm going to be their age, you know, and I'm going to be like talking to a youngin, like my daughter being like, you don't get it, you know? And you know, I think that that's obviously, you know, you can see that. It's clear. It's like two different worlds kind of trying to mesh, but also the women are all pretty, like, you know, they're open-minded and stuff. I mean, maybe it didn't seem like it with the tattoos and everything, and that really did surprise me, to be honest. I was like, oh my god,
me too.
Are you guys like, I was like, everyone had like all the people whose music you listen to and the designers at all your favorite fashion houses like have tattoos. Everybody has a freaking tattoo. It's like, I'm basic because I have tattoos. Like, I'm a basic bitch. Like, it's pretty normal these days. So that was very surprising.
Are we going to see you dating at all this season?
So, there's a guy that like I talk about a little here and there, but it doesn't, I'm not gonna say, but you're not gonna, no, you're not really, you're not gonna see me go on a date or anything like that.
Maybe season 13.
Yeah, maybe, because I literally haven't been, even though I'm very tempted to go on a dating app.
Where would you have worn that little Kim dress to? You had to have had that hanging like to wear to somewhere special.
I found it online, and I just, because I love Little Kim, really, she's like the her music and her whole vibe, and just people will try to look at her and say she's anti-feminist because like that's what people were saying when she came out, and to me she was like the most empowering because she's like, I'm gonna flip this whole misogynistic way of thinking and be like, actually, f- you, I'm making you eat my pussy and buy me a bag. And I was like, whoa, she just flipped it on all the dudes and like has all the power now, you know? But I found that dress and I'm like, I need to wear this. And I wasn't expecting to wear it to Sonja's fashion show. I was gonna wear it at some point, but I didn't know when. But then once I got that outfit, I was like, oh, hell no. I'm like, I'll wear the little Kim dress there.
Well, Leah, thank you so much for joining us. This was fun.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
Loving this season of New York and can't wait to see more.
You'll see a lot more. And also, I love Betches, by the way. I think you guys are amazing. Yay.
Thank you.
All right, stay safe and stay sane, guys.
You too. Thank you, Leah. Thank you so much.
Bye.